Now, the last session of this conference, we have Ms. Radhika talking on translation with TransFX, automating Apache Cloud Stack under translation. Ms. Radhika, an open source enthusiast at Citrix, brings in more than 9 years' experience in different fields of technical communication, including IT journalism, courseware development, science journalism, and software documentation. She is an Apache Cloud Stack emitter and Apache Cloud Stack Media India Meetup co-organizer. She has rich experience working in open source projects such as GNOME and Apache. Over to you.
Thank you, Annie. Good afternoon. And I'm very glad and, of course, privileged to be here and to have this opportunity to talk to you. I would call this gathering a mini India, am I right? People from different background, domains, who speak different languages, have come together for a common cause: content, collaboration, and consistency. Of course, I'm getting a sense of national integration, a kind of purely not setting standards for standard for localization, but also for national integration. Congrats, Red Hat, and CDAC, of course, Rajesh. So national integration is, of course, is not my topic. Coming back to my topic today. Today I'm talking about TransFX, translation workflow automation tool or a platform, and how TransFX is integrated and effectively fit into our current infrastructure, Apache Cloud Stack infrastructure. So before I dive into the session, let me ask you two questions. How many of you have used TransFX here? Good number. So, and how many of you have heard about Apache Cloud Stack? Yeah, okay. Good number. Not a good number. So to the people who have not heard about Apache Cloud Stack, it's an open source cloud computing from Apache. It's a very young open source project. It's hardly 1.5 years old. It's an infrastructure as a service cloud platform that builds enterprise as well as cloud service clouds. What exactly does is, in layman words, it's virtualize the data center, and so that end user can go and pick up any Linux machine or Windows machine or server or anything. You need not worry about anything. Credits, of course, I wanted to say thanks to a couple of people. Sebastian and David are our Apache Cloud Stack localization coordinators. Of course, community, without them, the product is not possible. An ecosystem is not possible. Thank you. And Dimitris Glisas, he is the brain behind TransFX, who keep helping us with any troubles that we face. We keep asking for our comments, feedbacks. And of course, Pure Guild, you gave me this opportunity to talk to a wider, diverse audience. So we will be going through a few slides. First, I would like you to get acquainted with the Apache Cloud Stack documentation. Then I will cover like what we do, how we do translation, and then I'll move on to TransFX website. And if we have time, I want to give a demo on the TransFX client. It's a command line client for people who are comfortable using the command line option. Documentation. So we write in XML files, and to apply style on the structure, we follow docbook. I think most of the open source projects follow docbook. Of course, like code documentation is also is pushed to Git. So if you wanted to contribute to Apache Cloud Stack documentation or UI, you have to Git clone the repo. So we have a directory under the Apache root directory, a doc directory. And public Git is one reason we, you know, the tool that we use to generate documentation artifacts. Thank you, Red Hat Jeans. It's an awesome tool. It works well. In between, it's PDF, only for PDF, and suddenly started, you know, generating PDF. No reason to laugh. We are happy with Publican. And Jenkins, of course, for continuous build, we integrate with Jenkins. So for the reviewers, anytime you can go and check the server, you can see the latest documentation. And for authoring, I use Oxygen, and it's up to the community contributors to use any tools they are comfortable with. So documentation process is simple like any other community. We start our discussion, functional spec discussion on the mailing list. Once the features are finalized, the release manager creates the ticket feature, and the documentation UI QA will have a sub-task under the main feature ticket. So if you are interested, feel free to, you know, sign up any feature you are comfortable with and start documenting. And once you're done with the documentation, what you do is, if you are a committer, you have earned the committer right, you can directly check in the files to the Git repo. If you are not a committer yet, you are a contributor, you have to go through a review process. So you have to create a diff, something called patch, XML patch, and submit on the review board. And that's and invite the reviewers for comments. The reviewers can give the comments, and then once it is fixed, you can incorporate the changes, and then it gets fixed. The committer can pick up the patch and ship. You can Git apply patch. So this is the process that we follow. And effects is filed on Jira. This is a screenshot of review board and an illustration about like how, you know, code, documentation, UI, everything is works. Jira, clone it, submit a patch and ship it. So translation, so how it works is, for each XML file, there is a corresponding portable object file. So we use portable object file for translation. So public anyone can translate strings. So that's why one reason I'm here. We have translator for other languages, but not in Indian languages. If you are passionate about localization and you would like to contribute to a cutting edge, innovative open source cloud computing, welcome. We have a project set up. I'll come to that point. So feel free to, you know, get in touch with us, and we need Indian translators. So don't worry, many of us translators and writers, you know, we don't want to work with source code. With Transifex in place, we need not worry about working with source code. Transifex. So Transifex is a platform. I would say it's a bridge between the development team and the translation team. It has a web interface as well as a command line option. So to start, you should have a account, and you can use social login. So here I have used my Twitter account to log in. So when if you want to contribute to the project, you can sign up on Transifex. It's very simple. Give your username, password, and go ahead with a standard procedure or any social login. So you log in it and search for Apache CloudStack. So I have already signed up for the project. This is the projects for Apache CloudStack. You can see this is a dashboard. This is the organization activity. April, there was a release. That is the time it had the highest number of translation. I mean, those things got translated, and then you can say it deteriorated. And we are getting a release in September. Probably it will go up. So we have documentation. We have Publican itself, translating Publican itself is a project, and Runbook, it's a quick installation guide kind of a project, and UI, and again, a straight quick QIG, it's a installation guide. So these are the projects. So if any of you are interested to, you know, contribute, go and directly sign up. So the interesting part is like, if you have an account and if you want to start a project, in Transifex, a project is not associated with an account. It's associated with the organization, and under each organization, you can have different roles. Reviewers, coordinators, and the team. any normal team member. So you can see, okay, it's a bit slow. So we can simply can see a list of popular product localization. You can see Fedora on cloud. So you can simply search for Apache. You can see you will get it. So go here, select it. So you can see the languages. So you can see a list of maintainers, and you can see the languages. It's getting translated. Yes, English is the source language. Chinese, Japanese, Portuguese, Thai, and we have Hindi, but very little. Kannada, Malayalam. Yes, we need translators. So here you can go and see the progress, how much it is getting translated. You can request a language. Suppose you want CloudStack to be localized in Telugu or any other language. For example, you can request a language. And you can go to Chinese, for example. It's a bit slow. Okay. So you can see the translation progress here. You can join the team. If you're comfortable with Chinese, you can join the team and it's translated. Again, I'm going back to dashboard. So I'm selecting CloudStack. See the resources. So you can see, what you can see is the port files. Each port file will have a corresponding XML file in the Git. I'll show you the directory structure. So you can just click when you start. So you can see. So my mother tongue. You can translate. Click translate. I don't know how. What is the Malayalam translation for clusters? So I don't know what I'm going to type it here, but so you can see a dashboard, a editor. You can see these strings. These are the strings. So you can directly type in. I have a Google translator. I selected Malayalam and I just type. This is what I know, cluster I don't know. Probably I should learn. So type in your translation and save it. Once you save it, the coordinator will automatically get to know that you have saved it. If your project has a reviewer, reviewer can come and you have a suggestion box. For a reviewer can give suggestions and you can come back and fix it. You can comments. It's a bit slow. Okay, it's kind of slow. So you can save it. So after the translation is done in Apache CloudStack, what there is no automated. I mean, it's not Git and Transifex is not yet synced. So the coordinator pull the PO files, translated PO files, and check it to Git. Once it is checked in, use publican commands to create the guides or the UI. So I'll show you the directory structure. So I'll show you a directory structure here. You can see this is the Apache Cloud. Sorry. You can see the directory here. So you have the doc directory, and you can see the different languages port file. It's created from publican update port. You will get the port file. So I'm running out of time, and about client, I'll talk about the client. So there is a command line option. It's very simple. Sorry. So it's a Python based client. So it has it work on Windows. You can download the EFC. So I have a client installed here. You can do a pip install on Linux or Mac. It's all the same. And so you can start with the command initialization text ts init. So it will initialize and so it initially will create the configuration file. Then you can set, run the ts set auto remote. It shows where the project is, all the source files are resides on Transifex, and you can pull it using ts pull -s. You can pull all the translation so that you will not replicate the effort, and you can do the translation on the any method that you are comfortable with. And after that you can just push ts push -l and the directory. So I can show you the directory, how it looks. So this is the TX client. So you can see the translation. This is ACS. You can see how many languages it has created the port. You can see British. So you can directly type in your translation and push. After your port file is pushed to Transifex, the coordinator pull and push to Git and run a simple publican command. I will show you demo, at least that I have wanted to show you. So I have set up a demo purpose document. Here is the doc. So here are the port files for Malayalam. So I'm just running a command on publican. So publican, sorry, publican build format. I'm giving HTML. Then I'm specifying the. I'm giving YAML IN, and then I'm specifying the configuration file config. What kind of file it is? I mean, what file of book it is? Equals. It's the release notes. It's a dummy release notes. Sorry. So it creates. It auto publican has the intelligence to pick up the file Malayalam files from the respective directory. So you can see and show you. Here is the doc. Here is the Malayalam translation. Very minimal translation I done for the purpose of showing you. So here, Ian. Sorry. You can see Malayalam HTML file is generated. It may not be the correct translation, but I did for demo purpose. So we are running out of time, and the last word, anyone would are interested and passionate about cloud technology and working with Apache, we will welcome to translate to Indian languages. Come forward and write to us. So I share the so we have a community here. Please do join the community and feel the difference of being in Apache. Yeah, that's all I have to say, and thank you. Any questions? If we have time, or
we have questions.
Sorry. As a writer or a localization team member, as an open source contributor.
Pain point when you're using Transifex.
Sorry, I
heard all the positive things, huh. Right? What is, do you feel the tool needs some feature that you find it's missing
one
or
thing,
problems?
Okay, so I'm not a Transifex expert yet, but something I notice is you can log the file, but concurrently two people can't translate. That is one point. And there is no chatting mechanism that you are explained in, yeah. That is not integrated yet. Other than that, probably as and when I go and explore, I might find. These are the two things I've noticed.
Yes, but we just
Okay. Okay, okay, not the translator.
We just had a thread, Mozilla list, that Transifex has changed their license and it's going closed source.
What is the future of open source?
Yeah, so it's not really a question, it's really a comment that perhaps as a user we have to talk to the developers and find out a way to do it, because it's a good tool and we would like to use it, but to invest in a tool that has uncertain future is really, it's a comment, it's just a comment. If any of us have, you're not very clear about that, it's been 5 months.
Yeah, we should write to Dimitris himself that please don't close source the tool many people are using. I think if I'm not wrong, OpenStack is using. So if OpenStack is of course an open source project, and if they are using the open source version of Transifex, I don't know if when Transifex is gonna close the source and how it is gonna work.
Yeah. I burnt my fingers a couple of times. Everyone knows that there is no good. I mean, it's an imperfect world, so every tool has its own things. But for that, someone mentioned the other day, when we choose a tool, what we look at is not have a like a vendor lock, and the data should be easy to pick up and move on. And that's my biggest concern with this moment. But I would like to hear if anyone has any additional comments and stuff like that. That's the reason I asked this. Thank you.